Welcome back. In this video, we are going to see the second search algorithm for the graph, which is known as DFS. So DFS stands for depth first search. Already in the previous video, we have seen how we can search a graph using breadth first search. So this is also similar to DFS with a small difference. So as usual, this search technique also starts with a node. We'll take it as A, and which is going to become the current node. Then you have to examine each node n along the path, which is starting from A. So let me make it clear. So you have to find, or you have to select a node that is going to be the starting node. And for the starting node, you have to find a neighbor. So if you take the previous case, we used to find all the neighbors which is unvisited. But in this DFS, what you do is you are going to select a node, and for the given node, you are going to find a neighbor, and for that neighbor, you are going to find the another neighbor. So this you are going to continue till you reach the last node. So let us see how does it work. So normally when we visit like this, we come across two kinds of edges. One is back edges. So these back edges are nothing but the edges which is already visited. Other one is known as discovery edges. So discovery edges are the new vertexes which we have not visited. So let me make it clear. We have two edges. One is discovery edge, other one is back edges. Discovery is nothing but which will lead to a new vertex which we have not visited. And back edges is nothing but these are the edges which will lead you to a vertex which you have already visited. So let us see the algorithm for this DFS. As usual, I told there is one major difference between DFS and BFS. The first difference in terms of data structure is, so this DFS take the help of stack. If it is BFS, which takes the help of a queue. So as usual, you have to define a stack which should have the capacity to store all the vertices in the given graph. Please remember what we have done for BFS. We have taken a queue which has got the size of number of vertices in the graph. Same way, we are going to take a stack which can accommodate all the vertices in the graph. Next, you are going to select any vertex, as I told, which can be any vertex, and which you are going to we are going to treat it as a starting point of traversal and visit that vertex and push it onto the stack. Before we used to push it onto the queue. Now we are going to mark it as visited and we are going to push it onto the stack. So after this, you are going to visit one of the adjacent vertex of the selected vertex, which is not visited, and you are going to push it onto the stack. Next, you have to repeat this step number 3 until there are no new vertex to be visited from the vertex on top of the stack. So every time you should have an eye on top of the stack. So what is there on top of the stack? You should make sure that you are going to visit all the vertex. So when there is no vertex to be visited, then you have a technique called backtracking and pop one vertex from the stack. So please remember, if you find there is no more vertex that is to be visited, what you can do is you have to take out the node which is on top of the stack. So one node at a time. Again, you have to continue this. You have to find it out which vertex is on top of the stack and visit, see that all the vertex you are going to visit. Once it is done, again take it out. You can pop one vertex at a time. So repeat this steps 3, 4, 5 until stacks becomes empty. Very simple. Okay. So let us, when stacks becomes empty, so then you can produce the final spanning tree by removing unused edges of the graph. So when we do it, we are going to get certain edges which is not used. You just remove it and you are going to get a spanning tree which is going to represent DFS tower cell technique. The way it will show the way your towers your graph, which is going to be obviously a DFS. So let us start. So you can consider a graph with 7 nodes, as you could see on the screen, which is starting with characters or alphabets from A to G. So we are going to visit it. What we do is you can select any vertex. So if you look at the given diagram, we have selected A as the starting vertex. You can see the change in color. A is the starting vertex and push A onto the stack. You can see that now we have a stack with a single element. Now we have to visit any adjacent vertex of A. Please note down the point, before we used to visit all the adjacent vertexes of the starting vertex. Now we are going to find any adjacent vertex. So we are going to take B as A's adjacent vertex. Even D is adjacent, even E is its adjacent, but we are going alphabetical order. So we have taken B as its neighbor and push B onto the stack. Now we look at the stack. We have got a stack with 2 elements. Next, visit any adjacent vertex of B which is not visited. Look at this. We started from A, B came to B, and for B we have found one adjacent vertex, and that is C, and push C into the stack. Now we can see that there is a stack with 3 elements, A, B and C. So visit any adjacent vertex of C which is not visited. So when you take C as the starting vertex, we are going to take E as the vertex which is not visited, and we are going to push this into the stack. So you can see the stack with 4 elements. Look at this. Next, visit any adjacent vertex of E which is not visited. So if you look at this, we will get it as D. From E, we have taken D as the vertex which is not visited. We are done with this. So again, if you look at the stack, we can get the stack with 5 elements. Continue this. There is no new vertex to be visited from. So after doing this, you have taken D as the vertex to be visited, and we are pushing to D. And when you take D, you can find that there is no more vertex which is not visited to be inserted on the stack. So what we should do? We should take it out. So we are going to take out D from that. So there are no new vertex to be visited from D. So sure, backtrack, or you are going to take out D from the stack. Next, who is at top of the stack? E is at the top of the stack. Again, for E, you have to find an adjacent vertex which is not visited. So if you take E, you can find it as F is the one which is not visited. So what you should do, you should push this into the stack. You can see that now F is pushed into the stack. Next, visit any adjacent vertex of F which is not visited. So if you take F, there is a vertex called G which is not visited, and push into the stack. So we have got a stack with 6 elements. Continue this. There are no vertex to be visited from G, so you should backtrack it. So you are going to take out G from the stack. So when you take out G from the stack, again F is going to be the top of the stack. Next, there is no vertex to be visited from F because all the vertexes we have visited from F. So what you can do is you can take it out. So when you take it out F from the stack, you will be getting E on top of the stack. Continue this. So there is no more vertex to be visited from E. So you can take out E from the stack. So when you take E from the stack, you are going to get it as C. Continue this. So there is no more vertex to be visited from C. All the vertexes has completed. So you can take out C from that. So when you take out C, you will be getting it as B and A. So again, continue with B. So when you take three